Here for an occasion of great joy and a cause for great celebration. Having found each other, they have built the kind of relationship that will serve them well as their foundation for their marriage. They wanted all of us here to witness their wedding vows as they join together as partners. Sarah and Barry are also gathered here together to celebrate the fact that they have shared 17 years of marriage together. And to renew their vows in solidarity with Debbie and Justine. For better, for worse, for richer, for poorer, in sickness and in health, they have found the strength in their love and commitment to endure and to enjoy all that has come their way. Each of us knows that a marriage is not created by a law or a ceremony. Rather, it occurs in the hearts of two human beings. It grows out of loving, caring, and sharing ourselves with another. And so it is that Debbie and Justine and Sarah and Barry have connected their hearts and souls, one to the other, drawing upon the depths of their being into the deep well of human need, the need to live united, loving, and complete. So in witnessing these ceremonies today, we are observing only an outward sign of an inward union that already exists between Debbie and Justine and Sarah and Barry. Today, they have come before us to publicly affirm their love, to promise to nurture themselves, each other, and this union, and to acknowledge its centrality in their lives. They do so knowing that marriage is at once the most tender, yet challenging, of all relations in life. Let us be there to see them through. We have several very special family member guests in the audience, which includes Debbie's mother, Sue Petrie, Justine's father, Dave Hollingshead, Justine's sister, Carla, and also Justine's cousins, Brenda Conrad and Jessica Rex, and Debbie's cousin, Sandy Kane. Debbie and Justine have asked that we take a moment to honor the memory of those loved ones who could only be here in spirit today. Our entrance song was in honor of Justine's mother, Chris Avery. The words to this song in English are as follows. In my fantasy, I see a just world where everyone lives in peace and honesty. I dream of souls that are always free, like clouds that float, full of humanity in the depths of the soul. In my fantasy, I see a bright world where each night there is less darkness. I dream of souls that are always free, like the clouds that float. In my fantasy exists a warm wind that breathes into the city like a friend. I dream of souls that are always free, like the cloud that floats, full of humanity in the depths of the soul. Sarah and Barry have not only shared a marriage, but have raised three wonderful children, Sam, Sophie, and Lucy, who are here this afternoon. They have formed a family of individuals who love and care for each other and who can count on each other to be there for one another. As this marriage has matured, it has taken on a life of its own. And within it, Sarah and Barry have individually evolved while growing in understanding of each other. This wonderful intimacy has mirrored a depth of inner knowing that has awakened levels of awareness they never knew existed. To be awakened in this way is a priceless gift. Sarah and Barry, please join hands to renew your wedding vows. You have traveled a long way together to reach this place today. In rededicating yourselves to each other, this marriage, and your family, you are affirming today that you are friends and choose to remain so. You are lovers and choose to remain so. You are individuals and choose to remain so. And you are partners and choose to remain so. Sarah and Barry, as you place these rings on each other's fingers, please reaffirm your marriage vows. Debbie and Justine, you have made a very serious and important decision in choosing to marry each other today. You are entering into a sacred covenant as life partners. As in tending the flowers in a garden, the quality of your marriage will reflect the effort you put into nurturing this relationship. You have the opportunity to go forward from this day to create a faithful, kind, and tender relationship. We bless you this day. It is up to you to keep the blessings flowing each and every day of your lives together. We wish for you the wisdom, compassion, and constancy to create a peaceful sanctuary in which you both can grow in love. Justine, do you understand and accept this responsibility? And do you promise to do your very best each day to create a loving, healthy, and happy marriage?
You do.
I absolutely do.
Debbie, do you understand and accept this responsibility? And do you promise to do your very best each day to create a loving, healthy, and happy marriage?
Yes, I do.
The Declaration of Independence, with a slight modification, stated, "We hold these truths to be self-evident, that all people are created equal, that they are endowed by their Creator with certain unalienable rights, that among these are life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness." Now is one of those historical moments that we have to remember what our country and society are all about. North Carolina is against hate. We are against bigotry. We hope for the future, for one day when equality can be realized for all. On Tuesday, May 8th, we decide whether we are for or against Amendment 1, or as I call it, the Vote Against Amendment. Let's be clear. Those that wanted this amendment on the ballot wished to write discrimination into the North Carolina Constitution. We need you, your friends, your family, your loved ones, everyone, to say no to discrimination and hate. Instead, spread a message of love. That message of love should be direct. That the LGBT community and ally individuals are appreciated and valued members of society in the state of North Carolina. We all are born with the right to live, live freely, and seek happiness. I do not understand why people would not support sanctifying love between two people like Justine and Debbie through marriage. While Justine and Debbie's marriage will not be recognized in this state, whether this amendment passes or not, they will still be married to one another on May 9th. This is because they understand that their love and marriage do not need to be recognized by others or the government, although preferable, to be real. We, as witnesses to this ceremony, understand the commitment they are making and will forever view their relationship as one of a married couple. Throughout the audience, there are 100 balloons. Please hold tightly to your balloon until instructed to release them. These 100 balloons will send forth awareness and hope to all 100 counties in North Carolina that marriage is about love, no matter the gender of the person you fall in love with. Collectively, you each represent the families and friends that have brought Debbie and Justine to this point in their lives. Please affirm your support for this marriage by responding, "Yes, I do," to the following question. As part of the community that surrounds Debbie and Justine, do you offer your love and support to strengthen their marriage and bless this family created by their union? Now please release your balloon as we release our balloons on stage. Beacon of hope that will spread across the state. We will now hear Justine and Debbie's vows and the exchange of rings. Debbie, do you take this woman as your partner and equal, your lover and your best friend, keeping yourself only unto her for as long as you both shall live?
Yes, I do.
Justine, do you take this woman as your partner and equal, your lover and your best friend, keeping yourself only unto her for as long as you both shall live?
Yes, I do.
If you could also repeat after me. Debbie, I gave you this ring. As a symbol of my promise.
As a symbol of my promise.
To always love you.
To always love you.
Cherish you.
Cherish you.
Honor you.
Honor you.
And respect you.
And respect you.
Justine, please repeat after me. I give you this ring.
I give you this ring.
As a symbol of my promise.
As a symbol of my promise.
To always love you.
To always love you.
Cherish you.
Cherish you.
Honor you.
Honor you.
And respect you.
And respect you.
By the power invested in me, I now pronounce that you are married. You may now kiss as a married couple for the first time. To conclude the ceremony, we will now have the cast from the NC State University production of Ren to perform Seasons of Love. During this performance, Debbie, Justine, Sarah, Barry, and I will join the audience, and there will be a community picture.